Alright, there's a video for 1VT and 1HT about exercise 20 till 25. I'm going to make a selection of these and explain them to you. First, we're going to start with exercise 20. It says, given is the formula y equals minus 3x squared minus 4. Calculate y, or find y, when x is minus 5. So I'm going to tell you how to do that. Now today, I'm going to write in red here. Hopefully you don't mind. This is the formula. The formula is minus 3 times x squared minus 4. And now we know that x is minus 5. So what you have to do is you have to take this minus 5 and we're going to fill it in over there. So if you do that, you get minus 3 times. And something that you learned earlier that you should remember now is that if the x is negative, then you have to put it in brackets when you square it. Because you want to do minus 5 squared. And if you put it in brackets, then it's going to go, well, you get minus 5 times minus 5 is 25. But if you forget the brackets there, then it's minus 5 times 5, and then it's minus 25, so this is where it goes wrong. Okay, so when the x is negative, you have to put it in brackets. So we get that, and then minus 4. So we calculate what this is, that's at 25, and then minus 3 times 25 minus 4, this is minus 75 minus 4, and then when you add that, you get minus 79. And that's the answer for 20A. Then we're going to take a look in the book for exercise 20b. It says there a new formula. The formula is g equals, in brackets, 5 minus n squared, and then plus 3. And they say find g when n is 9. So you see that sometimes these letters here, they can be a different letter than x and y. They can be, well, all sorts of letters. In this case, we know that n is 9. So we have to take the 9, and we have to fill that in over there. So I'm just going to copy this. So it says 5 minus 9 squared, and then plus 3. So 5 minus 9 is minus 4. So here we have minus 4 squared plus 3. And minus 4 squared is 16, and 16 plus 3 equals 19. So this was exercise A, this is exercise B. And underneath here, I'm going to write down exercise C for you. So let's see what exercise C is about. It says, given is the formula p equals 5q squared minus 2. And we need to find p when q is minus 1. Alright, so I wrote the formula down over here. And here we have q equals minus 1. So the minus 1 goes over there. And because it's negative, we have to put it in brackets. So I get 5 times, in brackets, minus 1 squared, and then minus 2. Now, if you calculate what this is, that's 1. Because minus 1 times minus 1 is just 1. And then 5 times 1 minus 2. 5 times 1 is 5, minus 2 equals 3. And there's also a way to just type this into your calculator. And I'm going to show that to you now, if I can find my calculator, which I can. So here, I have it. What you can do is 5, and then bracket open, and then minus 1. But for a negative number, you have to use this minus, and not that minus. This minus means you subtract something, so you remove something from a different number. This is for a negative number. So we have 5 times in brackets minus 1, and the squared button was over here, right, squared. And then the formula also said minus 2, so minus 2. And then here I get, it's a bit hard to see in the screen, you get 3, right? So also here we have 3. This is how you calculate exercise 20. Now let's take a look at what else we have here. Basically 21, 22, 22, and 23 and 24 are the same. You just have different formulas and then you need to fill something in. And then for 25, there we have something different because there you have a table that you need to fill in and then something special happens. So I will make this video, I'll also make this video about exercise 25. The formula here for exercise 25 is y equals minus 4x squared. Now we need to fill in this table. So we have a table that here we have x, here we have y. This is not the best line I ever drew, right? And here it starts at minus 4 and then it's going to go all the way to 4. So like that. Then we need to fill in all the missing values. So we need to calculate a lot. Now normally you have to write down all the calculations, but when you fill in a table, you don't have to. So in this case, we fill in minus 4, the minus 4 will be in there. I am going to write down the calculation here for the purpose of explaining this exercise, but what I write down now, you actually don't have to write down on a test. D minus 4 goes in there, so minus 4 squared. Now, if you want, you can type this into your calculator. If you do that, it will go like this. You do minus 4 times, and then in brackets, minus 4, bracket closed, squared. And that is it. So here it says minus 64. Alright, there's a secret function here on your calculator that I'll tell you about, because there's a way to fill in a formula. Let me see if I can actually find it, otherwise I'll tell you at the end of the video, because I think I have to, maybe have data, no. Okay, I think I'll tell you later. Okay, so if you have minus 3, then we have to do this, we have to do still minus 4 here, because the 4 doesn't change, then here we have minus 3 squared. So then you get this, you have minus 4 times, and then in brackets, minus 3 squared, squared, like that. And then here we have minus 36. So this was minus 36, this was minus 64. Right, and then you just fill in the next number. So here we have minus 4 times, in brackets, minus 2 squared. And there will be minus 16. And you will notice that this times here behind the 4 is actually not necessary, because if I do a bracket immediately, then that means times anyway. So sometimes you can leave a times away. Okay. Now this is, what does it say, minus 4. And then this is going to be 0. And with quadratic formulas, at some point, the numbers are going to repeat itself. Because if I fill in 1 now, yeah, let's fill in 1. You have minus 4 times in brackets 1, and the 1 is positive, so you don't have to put it in brackets, but you can if you want to. I mean, alternatively, we could have done this. Minus 4 times 1 squared, like that. Yeah, you get the same answer, see that? It's both minus 4. The screen is a bit unclear here, but if it's minus 4. Alright, so here we have minus 4. So what you see is that the table repeats itself, see that? Minus 64, minus 36, minus 60, minus 4, 0, and then minus 4 again. So this number will be minus 16 again, this number will be minus 36 again, and this number will be minus 64 again. So that is how you do that. And now I'm also going to tell you about the secret thing I have here on the calculator. I just found where it is. Okay, you have this table button here, see that? If I click on that, it asks me, what is the formula? So I can fill in this formula, I can fill that in there. So I'm going to do minus 4, and then in brackets. And then there is an X button somewhere, see that? It's this button, it says X, and some other letters. So now I have an X there, and then I'm going to do a squared here. See that? So we just filled in the formula there. And then it asks, where do you want your table to start? Well, I want the table to start at minus 4, so I'm going to say minus 4. And I want these steps to be 1, because every time it's one step higher, see that? And then we're going to do that. Yeah. And then here, see that? It filled in, calculates it for us here, minus 64, minus 36, minus 60, minus 4, 0. And then, I mean, it even goes further, right? You can just see the rest also. So that's nice, huh? You can use that if you want to. When you fill in a table, because we don't have a calculation now, right? But when you fill in a table, you don't have to write down calculations. So you can use that function. Otherwise, you have to use these calculations here. So hopefully this video was clear for everyone. Yeah, 25 is actually not yet finished. So I am going to say something about B and C also. It says here, B, what do you notice about the values of Y that you found? Well, what we notice here is that at some point, the numbers repeat itself again. That's what we notice here. And question C, when x is 26, y is minus 2,704. There is another x value that also gives you that answer. What value of x is that? Well, that answer for C would be x equals minus 26. Because if you fill in a negative number or the positive version of that number, you get the same answer. So if you fill in 26, you get the same answers when you fill in minus 26. Okay? So that was the video about 20 till 25. Hopefully it made sense to you. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.